In the last four PeopleSoft Update Images, PeopleSoft Travel and Expenses has made many updates. We've redesigned some of the classic Travel and Expenses module features, leveraging the Fluid User Interface. Some of these features are only available in the Fluid User Interface, not in the Classic version. We'll highlight the features that have been added to the Travel and Expenses modules, highlighting those features that originated in the My Oracle Support Idea Space. PeopleSoft Travel and Expenses enhanced the expense report, time report, and travel authorization documents. We also added a new analytic dashboard for users who create travel and expense reports for others. We'll talk about these enhancements, which image the feature was delivered in, and the PeopleTools release required for a particular feature. Let's start by making a wallet entry using the PeopleSoft Picasso Expenses Digital Assistant skill. Employees frequently lose money traveling on company business. They forget to keep track of cash paid for tips, taxis, and coffee, anywhere a personal or corporate travel card isn't used. Also, travelers using personal credit cards for their travel want to make sure everything charged on those cards are included in their expense report. First, let's click on the Picasso icon. Starting in PeopleSoft Update Image 41, you can quickly create a wallet entry with a few words, and it doesn't even have to be a full sentence. All you need to provide is the amount spent, what it was spent on, and the location. You can enter a previous date, or the system uses today's date. This easy-to-use option can help you keep track of your out-of-pocket cash expenditures by creating an entry in your wallet as soon as the expense is incurred. Picasso returns a summary of the wallet entry and provides an option to navigate to the wallet page to see the updates. The wallet shows the source of the entry and the information provided during the Picasso interaction. Let's take a look at the My Proxy Expense Report analytic dashboards. We added the My Proxy Expense Activity and Performance and Operations visualizations for expenses in PeopleSoft Update Image 40. The My Proxy Expense Activity dashboard allows users to view their own expense reports as well as reports they've prepared on behalf of someone else. This role is a proxy user. This could be the administrative assistant who enters executive expense reports. This dashboard allows users to analyze the activity, status, as well as any possible travel and expense policy violations on expense reports submitted for others. Please check out the video feature overview that discusses this analytic dashboard, as well as two others released in earlier PeopleSoft Update images. Now, let's check for duplicate expense lines. In PeopleSoft Update Image 41, the Expense Entry feature can check for duplicate expense lines across expense reports. When you save an expense report, the system displays a button that notifies you of any potential duplicate entry. The duplicate check looks for entries with the same date, expense type, amount, and location. If the duplicate is valid, like a charge for a cup of coffee on the same day, in the morning, in the afternoon, the user can enter a reason code to indicate why the duplicate is valid and continue to submit the expense report. Approvers have access to potential duplicate entries and the reasons provided by the submitter. Let's take a look at the bank account number encryption process to comply with the new National Automated Clearinghouse Association data security requirements. In Update Image 43, we enabled you to encrypt sensitive bank account data in compliance with the National Automated Clearinghouse Association and to comply with data security requirements for expenses and all other PeopleSoft modules. This feature allows you to encrypt, decrypt, and mask bank account numbers in FSCM tables. You can also identify, by role, who can view and maintain bank account numbers so that they can unmask the account numbers when necessary. Please note that this feature requires PeopleTools release 857.15. Users with the appropriate permissions can find a button on a page with a masked bank account number that allows them to see the full account number. Let's take a look at the ability to withdraw a fluid travel authorization. In Update Image 43, we enable users to withdraw travel authorizations even after submitting them for management approval. A withdrawn travel authorization returns to a pending status, and the user can edit, add, change anticipated expenses, or delete them if necessary. Notice the number of pending travel authorizations. Then, on a submitted travel authorization, clicking the Withdraw button returns it to the pending status. You can edit the travel authorization or choose an action from the drop-down. You can also delete the travel authorization. We've added the approval chain to the Fluid Travel Authorization page so that the traveler can see where their documents are in the approval process. If the travel authorization document is denied, they can see the approver's comments. Now, let's talk about the Tighten Up the Receipt Required functionality. In Update Image 43, we enhanced the receipt requirements for expense reports. Now, users cannot submit an expense report if receipts are required for the detail lines, but none are detected. An information tab on the business unit setup enables you to configure how the system reacts when required receipts are not included in the expense report. You can indicate whether or not receipts are required before submitting an expense report. Additionally, you can require receipts just for those charges not charged on a corporate travel card and imported into the expense system. You can also choose to require comments explaining the absence of a receipt and provide a default reason code for allowing the submission without a receipt. You can contain all receipts for the expense lines in an attachment at the header of the expense report. If the system detects a header attachment, it allows submission of the expense report without checking for a line attachment. When you have enabled the receipt required rules and the user clicks on the expense report submit button, the system reviews the content of the expense report for required attachments or a comment explaining the missing receipts. The system displays an error if any of the rules are violated. The error indicates what is missing and how to fix it before another submission attempt. You can now indicate on the user profile whether these new receipt requirements rules apply to an individual. You may excuse certain levels of users in your organization from providing receipts. You set this flag in the expenses user profile. Now, let's check for the enhanced time report to show approval chain. In image 43, you can now view the approval status of submitted timesheets. Once a user submits their time reported for approval and returns to the time report page, an approval button appears. This button enables the employee to view the status of their time report in the approval process. This is helpful if there are multiple approvers for the time report. In addition, the user can view any approver comments for denied reports or a time report sent back for additional information. Next, let's discuss the enhanced attachment functionality that allows users to add documents to expense reports after payment and the enhancement that allows uploading multiple attachments at one time. In PeopleSoft Update Image 44, we added an enhancement frequently requested through the idea space on My Oracle Support. Users and approvers can add attachments to expense reports that have been approved, queued for payment, and paid. Attachments can be added when the transaction is in an approved, staged, or paid status. Also, you can now upload multiple attachments in one upload session rather than one object at a time to all travel and expense documents that allow attachments. This feature enables the user to add multiple attachments of any type to their business documents. The user opens the upload window and looks for the receipts and attachment folder stored on their local drive. Hold down the Shift key and click on the files to attach to the travel document. Then, continue the uploading process as usual. When it's complete, you should see all the attachments you selected on that detail line. Note that this feature requires PeopleTools release 8.5.9 or later. These new expense features provide a better user experience. In addition, your organization can implement and configure better travel and expense policies. For more information, go to PeopleSoftInfo.com.